Right here with me in studio this morning, she's the creator of the popular food YouTube channel called Downshiftology, and it has nearly 2.5 million subscribers. She's out with her very first cookbook, Healthy Meal Prep, and she joins me now. Thank you for being
Thank
here.
Thank you, I'm excited to be here.
Congratulations Thank on all your you. Success. I think that's amazing.
Yeah, the YouTube channel has just been crazy the last couple of years.
And I love that you started it because you were just like, you know what? I want to teach people to eat healthy and easy, right?
Yes, it's all about simple, wholesome ingredients, naturally gluten-free, dairy optional, just makes people feel good.
Makes you feel good.
Yes.
So what are we making today, actually?
So today we are making baked oatmeal. It's a peaches and cream baked Ooh. Oatmeal. And it's perfect that if you're one of those that love oats for breakfast, mm-hmm. but you want to jazz up your morning oatmeal routine,
yeah.
this is a great option. It'll warm you up this time of year. So delicious.
I am a huge fan of baked oatmeal. I usually make pumpkin pie baked oatmeal.
Ooh.
Because I also yes. have issues with gluten. Now, I am not celiac, but it does make me things hurt, like
yes.
my knees and stuff
yes.
when I eat gluten.
A little inflammatory for some people. Just doesn't yeah. make you feel good sometimes.
It doesn't. So how do we get started making this beautiful dish?
So it's really easy. You're gonna start with some rolled oats, and I'm using certified gluten-free rolled oats.
Okay.
You will add, for a little bit of crunch, some sliced almonds.
Mm-hmm.
For a little bit of warming flavor, some ground cinnamon.
Okay.
Some baking soda.
Okay.
And some salt, and then you just want to whisk that together, if you
okay.
wouldn't mind
I can do that
just
for
whisking
you.
That together.
I saw that you use Himalayan salt, too.
Yes.
Okay.
And then you will mix the wet ingredients together. You've got 1 3/4 cup of milk, and you can use dairy or dairy-free.
Okay, can I use lactate?
You can.
Okay.
2 eggs.
Okay.
And then for... we've got some butter. You can also use coconut oil. Again, if you're going to go dairy-free, you can
okay.
swap that out. A little vanilla extract, because we love the little sweet vanilla flavor.
We do.
And then maple syrup. You can use maple syrup or honey. So
okay.
I always use natural sweeteners.
Okay.
No sugar in any
no
of my recipes.
Sugar.
No
sugar. Oh, okay.
And then,
you want me to, by the way, whisk this
yes,
for you?
Yes, you can
okay.
whisk that. And then for the peach flavor, we've got two options here on the peach, or two ways we've prepared the peach.
Okay.
This I've actually pureed. So this is a pureed peach, which you can puree in just a little, one of those 4-cup food processors.
Yeah, I have one of those.
Or you can put it in a mason jar with a stick blender and puree it up.
Oh, that's nice.
And so this gives you a little bit of that peach flavor throughout the whole breakfast casserole.
Okay, I love that.
So you can whisk that
So you can
together.
Do either or both, right?
So yeah.
I like a lot of peach flavor.
Exactly. So
okay.
that's one peach that is pureed.
Okay.
And then we've got two peaches that are diced. And so if you want to pour that into the dry ingredients.
Okay. And then
and
mix
then you'll
this
just
all together.
Mix that together.
Okay.
And the great thing about this too, if you don't have peaches that are in season right now,
yeah.
you can use frozen.
Oh,
you could use
yeah.
any frozen fruit as well.
Because it's going to bake up fine, right?
Exactly. And
yeah.
so that keeps it budget-friendly. You know,
yes.
oats are naturally budget-friendly. You can use budget-friendly frozen fruit as well. So
I
there's lots
that.
Of options.
Do you put those in there
yep.
first?
And then
okay.
we can just stir those together.
Fold in the peaches.
Fold in the peaches.
Okay. And then just pour. Wait, do you grease the pan?
You grease it.
Okay.
You can use coconut oil. You can use butter.
Okay.
Whatever you'd like on that.
You know what I do, by the way, with this? Because I do make, I bake oats a lot. I love this recipe. I'm so glad you showed it to me. Is I do it actually the day before, like on a Sunday afternoon.
Yes.
And then I can just heat it in the next morning when I'm a
So
zombie.
That is the topic of my cookbook, which is all meal prep.
Oh, yeah.
And this is one of the things that we love, is that you can bake this. So this will bake in the oven
mm-hmm.
for about 40 to 45 minutes. And when it comes out, it
oh,
will look like this.
Oh, that is beautiful. Yes.
And as you mentioned, it's great for meal prep.
So it is, and this is a lot of oatmeal. Like, this will feed your whole family for a week, no doubt.
And so what I like to do is I can slice it up into portions
mm-hmm.
and put it into individual containers and then just reheat those individual containers
oh,
in the morning before work or before I'm running out
yeah.
the door. And so there's lots of ways that you can meal prep it.
That's delicious. That is delicious. And how long can this last for? Like,
this will last for about 4 to 5 days in the fridge,
okay.
but you can also freeze it. So I'm big on freezing recipes.
Yeah.
Put it in your freezer for up to 3 months. And then when you want to thaw it, you just put it in the fridge the night before.
Okay.
Let it thaw overnight in the fridge and then pop it in the microwave or in the oven.
I love that too. And sometimes I just pour a little bit of milk over it yes. to like rehydrate.
Yes. And so when I'm serving it too, one of the things that I love to do is you can take a portion of it.
Mm-hmm.
Put it into a bowl, and then once you've got this, you can add some yogurt on top. And again, you can use dairy or dairy-free yogurt.
Oh, okay,
and it
like
just,
coconut yogurt?
Exactly, and it just keeps those breakfast vibes strong in the morning with a little bit of yogurt.
The presentation on that is lovely, too. All right, I want to make, now this I love, too, overnight oats. This is overnight oats, right?
Yes.
When I worked the morning shift and had to get up at the ungodly hour of 2 a.m., I lived on overnight oats. But this looks like not the oats that I have had before.
So I love to add chia seeds into my overnight oats.
Oh, okay.
It adds a little bit of fiber, some omega-3s, it keeps you full.
Yeah.
And as you said, overnight oats are great for a grab-and-go option. And I always say that it is the easiest no-cook breakfast option that there is. So it's just another way that you can have oats for breakfast, but you can put these in your purse or your bag, you can take them to work. And I've got...
What is in here? Yeah.
Yeah, so I've got some, it's an orange pistachio flavor.
Ooh.
And so you've got oranges, you've got a little bit of maple syrup, and you've got pistachios for crunch.
Ooh.
And again, you can use any fruit that's in season, any flavor combinations.
Ooh.
There's just so many options. Exactly. I mean, even mixed berries, I'll get one of those packets of mixed berries from, you know, Costco or the market, put it in there.
This is really good.
Yeah.
You gotta be careful though with the chia seeds. I'm just gonna warn you. Because if you are near a restroom, you wanna make sure you are. All right, let's talk a little bit more about your YouTube channel.
Yes. So I started my YouTube channel, gosh, about 5 or 6 years ago now.
Mm-hmm.
Started my website 8 years ago and started just putting healthy gluten-free recipes up. And people said, you know, we would love to see how you make these recipes. So when I started the YouTube channel, put that up. And of course, it was my meal prep video that went viral. And today it has more than 16 million
views. Is this it? Are we looking at the original?
No, this is not the original. This is actually a recipe from my cookbook, though.
Oh.
And so this is oranges and chicken breasts, and it's just super delicious. And so this, a couple of the recipes from my cookbook I already put on my YouTube channel.
Oh, nice.
But yeah, so there's a couple of different, that one is actually really great to meal prep and put in the freezer.
Okay.
But yeah, there's so many delicious options on the YouTube channel.
This is amazing. And it's just kind of things that we have in the house already, which I love. And I love that you've really incorporated, because right now with shopping is so, I was talking to my girlfriend on the way over to work today, and she's like, every time I go to the grocery store, I can't get out for under $100 now. So this is just such a great option to be able to make for your whole family. And it's very conscious in line with saving that money. Really quickly, before I let you go, can you help? Because like I was mentioning earlier, I'm not celiac, but a lot of times people are a little bit hard on you for not wanting gluten, or sometimes you kind of get sad when you can't have the gluten anymore. Do you have any like advice on how to deal with those feelings?
I first say, listen to your body. So if you eat gluten and it just doesn't make you feel well, whether you're celiac or not, you know, listen to your body.
Mm-hmm.
But for me, it's also not about recreating gluten recipes and trying to make them non-glutinous.
Right.
You know, it's more focusing just on healthy whole foods. And finding new favorites that are just very nutrient dense.
I love that. All right. Well, thank you so much, Lisa.
Thank
and
you.
All the recipes that she shared with us today are going to be on our website. Or you can just text the word recipe to 206-448-4545. We'll send you a link straight to your phone. And a reminder, Lisa is holding a book signing tonight, January 10th at 7:45 p.m. at Seattle's Book Larder in Fremont. You can get her book and have her sign it, but not this one because I'm keeping it for myself. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
All right. Well,